Good morning, Greenlight Today family. It is so good to be back with you. I hope everyone is doing well. You know, this past weekend, I had saw a special on PBS with Christiane Northrup. She's the woman who, I think, starting in the 80s, she began the series of Women's Bodies, Women's Wisdom, and it just really had a profound effect on the industry, health industry, psychological industry, of all the industries in which women are involved, helping women to reshape what's important to them, and really just forcing even medicine and science to say, hey, you don't know what you're talking about. We know our bodies. She's just been a really incredible game changer for women. And this past weekend, she was introducing her new book, Goddesses Never Age. And on PBS, I think the name of the special was Why Glorious Women Don't Age. And it's just so fascinating. I want to get a copy of it so I can, forward it on to my mom and other women. But she just had seven things that are blowing the myth away, out of aging, that we all need to think about, not just for ourselves, but for how we treat other people. So I wanted to share some of these things with you. I was taking notes as I was watching the show. So if you see the show and you're like, I got something off a little wrong, it's because typing and watching TV and trying to think at the same time is a challenge, at least for me. So anyway, you know, she started off saying what determines aging. And a lot of people say, well, your genes are the biggest factor in aging. And what they're finding out is that, yes, that may be true, but your thoughts and your environment are the number two indicators that change how you age. I come from a long line of women who live past 100. But my environment and my thoughts may totally change that for me. And she gave this example of how I think there were like 50 to 70 year olds that they put in a monastery. So everything was controlled, right? And what they did is that they showed them movies of, you know, favorite movies as they grew up, favorite TV shows, their favorite foods, things that they like to do, talking about their favorite memories. And I think they were in the monastery for a couple weeks. And when they got out, what they found was that the aging had reversed. They looked like 5 years younger. All their vitals had changed. So your environment and your thoughts can affect how you age. The first thing we need to do then after that is reframe our own meaning of aging. Do you know that doctors consider aging a pathological disease? We get to a certain point in our lives and the doctors think we're diseased. That is crazy. We need to reframe what aging means. Maybe aging for you means I'm expanding my wisdom. And I love what she said. You know, when people ask you your age, or people ask me my age, or do I have kids? There's some things that people ask me. I think they're trying to figure out who I am. And one of the responses that I'm going to give that she had said was, you know, in wisdom years, I think I'm only about 30, but I'm trying to catch up. And let it go, right? Number one, do you know who the fastest growing segment of the population is? Nope, not baby boomers. Nope, not millennials. 90-year-olds. 90-year-olds are the fastest growing population in America. Now, they won't tell you that on TV, right? They think that, oh, you know, you got to be young, you got to be this. Don't believe the hype. And the marketers are finding out that they need to change their whole framework for marketing, because the people with the money, with the buying power in this country are the 70-year-olds. I just love this. Okay, so number one, reframe your own meaning of aging. Number two, adjust and change the cultural programming. Now, we had different expectations of aging, because when they first started studying aging in 1880, the life expectancy was only 18 months past the age of 65. That's why so many things are set at 65, because in 1880, that was the norm. You were only going to live 18 months on average past the age 65. Now it's 79. And if you've lived a life where your environment and your thoughts have produced a lot of positivity in your life, add 7.9 years. So this whole framework of aging is from the 1800s, okay? We need to change that. Number three, stop participating in ageism. I love this. First thing she says is stop saying, I'm having a senior moment. Because you know what? That's not a senior moment. We are getting, let's see, I know 254 times more information on a daily basis than they were in 1900. 250 more times information. You're not having a senior moment. Your mind is doing a wonderful job of keeping track. And she says, don't take the senior discount. And she gave these examples. I mean, I don't qualify for it, but, you know, of people who actually take the discount and then the wait time and going in separate lines and separate this and separate that, that actually added on, you know, subtracted actually more years from their life. So don't take it. Don't let someone else's biology co-author your life. Don't be around people who talk about, oh, you know, this is what happens when you get old and, oh, you know, this is what you got to look forward to. Don't let them co-author your life. Growing older means you move through time and space and you increase your value and compensation. Think how much space we've gone through. How much more valuable that is, right? Let's see. The third largest economy in the world, which has a combined gross national product of U.S. and China, are those over 50. Don't let anybody sell you short on your value. Okay. Number four, enjoy a sweet life without raising your sugar levels. I think that's like diabetes or whatever. And they just have all these studies that people who really enjoy life decrease their cortisone, decrease their stress, decrease this excess sugar that happens when you're stressed away from your stomach, because excess stress, when it has no place to go, when that cortisone has no place to go, turns into stroke, heart attack, and diabetes. And they're saying, they haven't proved it yet, but this is what she said, that Alzheimer's may in actuality be the third type of diabetes. Whoa. Okay. Fifth thing, move. Functional fitness. You know, you don't have to do an hour a day of working out. Functional fitness. For every hour that you sit, get up and do something. And during the show, we did like 20-second burst of moving, and it did make a difference. It was really good. Sitting increases your chance of death by 40% because your fascia, which is like a crystal, it's like the sheath outside your muscles and your skeletal network. If it's not moved, it can turn into scar tissue. And this is like having 2,000 pounds of pressure on your body. So move. Do something pleasurable, because if you don't enjoy it, you're not going to sustain it. For me, my number one exercise is walking. I love to walk. Number six, develop a centenarian consciousness. I probably say that wrong. Centenarian? Anyway, the 100-year-old is what I'm trying to say, consciousness. They did a study on most people who live to be 100 and enjoying their lives. They had four qualities. They were rebels. They were defiant. They were future-oriented and pleasure-oriented. They don't look all being around people who have that ageism mindset. They have sustainable rituals. You know, if they want to get up and have a glass of wine, they do it. I had a neighbor, and I didn't know how old she was. At that time, I think she was 87. And she goes, oh, come on, have a glass of wine with me. And I was like, okay. And do you know her nieces, who were her guardians, said, don't do that. She should not have a glass of wine. That was her ritual. That's what she enjoyed. Now I know these things. Share positive moments, share good news. Number seven, hang around people whose behavior is contagious. Community equals immunity, and I love this. We need supportive tribes. If you are around people who have no age consciousness, that's your tribe. If you're around people who are creative and doing and are just really, really enjoying life, that's your tribe. Anyway, I know that I didn't get all the notes from the show, and I probably talked way too long right now, but I just wanted to share those things from the show. If you get a chance, it's on PBS. I don't know if they're showing reruns. Her book is Goddesses Never Age by Christiane Northrup. All right. I hope you have an ageless, awesome day. Talk to you later. Bye.